The VLOOKUP function in Excel is pretty straightforward, but it can get tricky when you have duplicate values in your table. Today, I'm going to show you how to solve this problem in less than 5 minutes. Hi, welcome to Productivity Land, the channel where you'll learn Excel without dying of boredom in the process. Today, you'll learn how to use the VLOOKUP function to handle duplicate values, a common issue that actually has a simple solution. The best way to master Excel is through practice. So if you want to follow along, I've included a link in the video description where you can download the worksheets I'll be using. All right, let's get started. Imagine you work in Apple's finance department and you need to analyze the sales data for the products in this table. Now, let's say you need to find the sales for iPhones specifically in the United Kingdom. But as you can see, there are duplicate values. iPhone shows up in three different rows. Let's see how to tackle this using a standard VLOOKUP, step by step. First, let's break down the VLOOKUP function. It requires three main arguments and one optional one. Here's how they work. The first argument is the lookup value. In this case, we want VLOOKUP to search for the product iPhone, so we'll select the cell that contains iPhone. This keeps the formula dynamic, so it'll still work if you change the product in the cell. The second argument is the range where VLOOKUP will search for the data. This range should include both the column with the lookup value and the column with the data you want to retrieve. Here, we'll select the range A2 to C7. It's super important to lock this range so it doesn't change when you copy the formula. You can do this by manually adding dollar signs or just hitting the F4 key after selecting the range. The third argument is the column number where the data you want is located. In this example, the sales data is in the third column of the range, so we'll type 3. The fourth argument is optional and specifies whether you want an exact or approximate match. We'll type false to ensure we get an exact match. When you press enter, the result will be 387,000, which is the sales for iPhone in the USA. But we wanted the sales for the UK, right? Here's the issue. VLOOKUP always returns the first match it finds in the table and ignores any other rows that meet the same criteria. So even though there's another row with iPhone in the UK, we can't get it using this method. To fix this, we'll use a helper column that combines the product and country values. This will create a unique key for each row, allowing VLOOKUP to differentiate between duplicate values. Start by creating the helper column. In a new column, enter the formula equals B2 ampersand C2. This formula combines the value in B2, the product, and C2, the country. For example, if B2 contains iPhone and C2 contains USA, the result will be iPhone USA. Drag this formula down to fill all the rows in the column. Now we've got unique keys that let us look up specific combinations, like iPhone UK, and get the corresponding sales data. Next, let's build the VLOOKUP formula using the helper column. The first argument is the lookup value. Here's where we use a neat trick. Something not many people know is that you can concatenate values directly in your lookup value. To find iPhone in UK, we'll combine the product and the country directly in the formula with F2, ampersand G2. This dynamically creates the value iPhone UK that VLOOKUP will search for in the helper column. The second argument is the range to search. This time, we'll expand the range to include the helper column. Don't forget to lock the range by pressing F4 after selecting it. The third argument is the column number where the data you want is located. Since the sales data is now in the fourth column of the range, we'll type 4. For the fourth argument, since we still want exact matches, we'll again type false. When you press enter, you'll get the result 554,000, which is the sales for iPhone in the UK. If you change the product or country in cells F2 and G2, for example, to AirPods and USA, the formula will look up AirPods USA in the helper column and return the correct sales data automatically. No adjustments needed. And now, YouTube says this next video will turn you into an Excel wizard. Watch it or stay stuck in spreadsheet purgatory forever. No pressure, right? See you there!